to a land beyond dreams.
Yes. Yes. Have that tune stuck in your head forever. This is the perfect way to start October in the most horrifying fashion possible.
Oh my gosh, Madhog singing! What horror has been left upon the world?
I am a princess from a Disney knockoff.
Ah, King's Quest 7.
Yes.
Its memory will live forever in our nightmares. And speaking of nightmares, welcome back, children of the net, to the town that wants you dead. I have a tagline at some point, but I misplaced it. Anyway, this year, as we promised last year, we are going to be reading Silent Ponyville 2, the sequel to the, I think, acclaimed Silent Ponyville story that we kind of liked, but also kind of not, because of all the grammar misspellings. But the story was good. It was suspenseful, and it was suspenseful.
Suspenseful.
It was suspenseful, and it was scary. It was atmospheric, and it was engaging. It was everything a good horror story needed to be in order to succeed and grab your attention.
Yes, so welcome back, my little children of souls.
It's a bit too late for that, Tavar. Anyway, Silent Ponyville 2. Just like the original story, I did a review of this story as well. My old fanfiction R&R video. Here's a card. Go check it out. The audio is not so great, but anyway. Now, I'm going to summarize what my main point of that review was. Consider this some sort of an introduction to this story as well, in case you don't know it already. Now, my main point was that this story was simultaneously better than the original and not as good. How does that work, you might be asking? Right? Are you asking that?
I'm just gonna save my judgment for myself personally, but but playing as everyone on the net, I'll go. Jeez, Madhog, whatever do you mean by that?
Well, I'm so glad you asked. And at this point, you should say me because it's the sketch from the Muppets. Anyway, okay. On one hand, Silent Ponyville 2 is a better written version of Silent Ponyville 1. It tells a slightly better story. It is more scary. It is more emotionally involving and distressing. It has cooler monsters. In fact, the main one is actually a fully original monster, as opposed to a reskinned
Slender Pony.
Yes, as opposed to the Slender Pony, also known as Slender Mane. Which doesn't make any sense, because it doesn't have a mane, but, you know, punny. So, all of that, and also the protagonist is Fluttershy, which, as you know, it's the bar's favorite one pony, isn't
Yay.
It? Yes, it is. So, and this is all about her and her own nightmares, and her own twisted and tormented subconscious mind that gets manifested once she visits the mental version of Ponyville, which is exactly what happened to Pinkie Pie in the first story. So, for all this reason, Silent Ponyville 2 is a better Silent Ponyville than Silent Ponyville. But at the same time, it's almost exactly like Silent Ponyville. And I'm not just talking about how the story is generally structured, as in she has nightmares, she goes to Twilight, Twilight does the Twilight thing to do.
And the Ooga Booga thing.
The mind delve spell, and she gets stuck in the Silent Ponyville subconscious horror town and whatnot. And she has to discover what does it all mean and come into some sort of revelation that will automatically save the day. It plays exactly like the first one. But not just from a general structure standpoint. It downright retraces specific scenes from the original story, especially the beginning and the climax. They are played out in the exact same way.
Oh dear.
So, like I said, it is a, in my opinion, a better version of the first story, but it is so derivative of the first story, so much of it is retraced from the original story, that for this reason it will never be as popular as the original story.
Well, I guess that means we've already done the story then.
No, because like I said, there is a slightly more interesting story, and also it is scarier, and it's more violent.
Oh.
So, and it's longer too. It's the
9 chapters.
Well, I think. Yes. Actually, 7 chapters as opposed to 5 chapters. So, yes, it's longer.
And not counting 4, 5, 6, 7 endings.
Yes, not counting all the endings, the many, many endings. So, let's get started. Oh, and one more thing you should know about this.
Yeah.
Technically, you were supposed to read another story before this one, Too Shy for a Rainbow, which is a very fluffy slice of life kind of story in which Fluttershy and Rainbow Dash get together as a couple.
I'm sure we'll catch up on it.
It's the prologue to the story, basically. In fact, the story starts off with Rainbow Dash and Fluttershy already as a couple. Now, the reason why I say personally that you need to read this story in order to enjoy better Silent Ponyville 2 is because knowing how they got together, and you take that and you recontextualize it in the story at hand in Silent Ponyville 2, it makes what they go through together far more emotionally powerful. But we don't have time for that, so let's just get started on Silent Ponyville 2.
Alright. Okay, so we'll start with a summary, which has gore, romance, sad, dark crossover in it.
Well, technically it's not a crossover, it's more of a hybrid story, because it's not literally a crossover between the two universes.
Yeah.
It's basically an element inspired from a game, transplanted into a specific universe. Like I said, hybrid, not a crossover.
Yeah. But... Alright, should I read this then?
Yes.
Alright then. It's been a month since Fluttershy and Rainbow Dash started dating. Everything was going fine until Fluttershy started experiencing horrific nightmares that started keeping her up at night. Looking for answers, Rainbow Dash, Fluttershy and Pinkie Pie seek out Twilight. Because why not? She finally fixes everything when it comes to nightmares.
Actually, here's something I don't like about this story. It completely shoehorns Pinkie Pie in it.
Yeah.
I mean, seriously, it's completely random the way Pinkie Pie was shoehorned into the story. You could say, oh, well, Pinkie Pie, she is random, so you know. But no, it doesn't work here. It's... Okay, you'll see what I mean later on, but... okay, the beginning of the story was not encouraging. It gets much better, but it feels like the franchise, so to speak, is already jumping the shark. It is not. It will jump the shark with the third installment of this trilogy.
Oh, gosh.
Which we are not going to read because A, it's too long, and B, it sucks.
Yay!
So, Silent Ponyville 2 is going to be the conclusion of this. Okay?
Okay.
But
when the three mares find themselves within the world of Silent Ponyville, will things turn out for the better?
All three of them are going to visit Fluttershy's mind, basically. So Pinkie Pie, she had her own story, her own arc concluded in the first... I was about to say game, in the first story. And now she goes back in it a second time.
But in another pony's mind.
And you know what?
What?
She goes back in it a third time in Silent Ponyville 3, along with everybody in the town.
Oh, gosh.
At that point, it just becomes completely ridiculous.
Anyway, will things turn out for the better, or will things end in tragedy?
You already read that, actually.
No, I actually didn't end, I didn't actually finish that until you jumped in.
Okay, sorry, I did...
Okay.
I feel the need to point out why this and this is that and why this and this is the other thing.
Okay. Into chapter one we go then.
All right.
Chapter one.
Okay.
Author's notes.
We don't need to read those. It's basically, again, it tells you what I already told you about Too Shy for a Rainbow. It's the prologue to the story. Rainbow and Flutters get together and they are a couple.
Yeah.
Etc. So chapter one, let's get reading, little buddy.
Okie dokie.
I'm going to start, if you don't mind.
I don't mind.
We're going to go with the usual formula of alternating paragraphs with each other. We haven't done this in a while, come to think of it.
Yes, this has been a while.
All right. Oh, you want to do Fluttershy?
Oh, so it's Fluttershy first.
It is.
Okay. How does it make that sound?
It's actually young Fluttershy.
Oh.
I was going to accept, how does it make it sound? That's okay too. A young filly
stared.
A young filly stared, hypnotized by the gentle music caressing her ears. The small box before her let out a harmony that reminded her of angels. A stupid bunny. The warm body next to her grew closer, nuzzling up against her.
I don't know the details myself,
an older mare's soothing voice swept through her ears, as if the voice itself was trying to hug her. Metaphors already going overboard. Her voice was soft yet delicate, but it's just like an instrument. Every piece is finely tuned, so that when a chord is struck, it plays a gentle note.
Crazy lady, I think you were off your meds or something.
Actually, you're kind of hitting the nail on the coffin here.
Carry on.
It's you.
Oh, okay. Carry on, Devar. Oh, well, thank you, please. Devar.
But it only plays one song.
I'm sorry, are they beating you to death? That's the kind of voice you're having. They kill your puppy. The young filly mused as she continued to stare, comforted by the warmth of the other with her. Of the other with her. Okay?
And it seems a little sad.
She leaned her head against the bigger body, resting against it.
You've already said it's... Okay, maybe I'm wrong.
Yes, I suppose it does sound a little sad. Cough, cough.
The older mare smiled warmly, her long mane falling in the filly's face. The little filly giggled a little as the air... Thank you. Tickled her face. Before moving it out of the way to smile at the music box. Of course there has to be a music box in Silent Hill. I mean, Silent Ponyville.
Yeah, just be creepy.
But this music box is very special to me.
The older mare sighed happily.
I like it.
The filly smiled happily, closing her eyes as she listened. The melody softly flowing through her ears.
I want to go to a land beyond dreams.
That's the melody.
You're going to beat that song to death, you know, someday.
I think I'm already on it. Anyway, where was I?
She couldn't help but think it was beautiful, I think.
This might happen, closing her eyes, the melody, blah, blah, blah. Thank you. She couldn't help but think it was beautiful.
Please, never forget that I love you.
I think I know where this is going.
I think everyone knows where it's going.
The older mare's voice grew quiet with those words. Also, because this part of the text is actually written in italic, you know it's a dream.
I know, Mother. I love you too.
The filly nuzzled against her mother happily. The older mare grew quiet as the filly nuzzled... saying nuzzling, nuzzled too many times. dear old, writer of these stories. What was it? Sam Rose. His name is Sam Rose. Dear old Sam Rose. Yes, your style is, impossible to confuse. I wonder if you're going to come across a legitimate new series of With All Our Might.
Yeah, but instead, nuzzling.
I really hope there is a With All Our Might, because I want to restart that counter.
Oh, gosh.
There was a silence that filled the air, only being filled by the gentle and calming music from the box.
Mother?
The young filly broke the silence, but it soon returned. The chimes of the music seemed to slow down, drawing out each individual note, much like I am drawing each individual word out. Like this.
Mother?
She called again, lifting her head up to try and look at her mother. The older mare had suddenly grown quiet.
Mother, say something.
Hello, mother.
Hello, father. Here I am, in captionary.
All right. The filly pleaded, pushing against her mother with her hooves. Okay, they say mother too many times, nuzzle too many times. Right.
Hello, trying mother. To get her... Hello, nuzzle.
All right. Trying to get her attention. Come on, mother senpai, notice me. The mare's body felt like it was growing colder, wobbling a bit before falling over.
Jesus, corpse is going to rot before her very eyes any moment, I bet.
You're once again hitting the nail on the coffin.
God damn it! Do we have to have a horror cliche counter?
No. The older mare lay on the floor, her hair looking like cobwebs on the ground, her coat growing dull, her immoving form.
Unmoving.
Oh, it almost seemed like an eye.
I know, the italics is hard to read.
Okay. My face is not attached to the screen, I should say. Her unmoving form framed against the darkness of the ground.
Mother!
Earthbound! We have to go back play that some of these days. The young filly cried, pushing her hooves against her mother as the music box continued to slow down, each note ringing in her head that something was wrong.
What is this? Is this like the heart monitor of Ponyville?
Yeah. 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 He died. The filly moved her hands. Hands? I've seen this mistake done in the previous story too.
Actually, it's an honest mistake.
Her hands away from her mother and stared at her hooves. Why do I suddenly have fingers? What
oh
is this
gosh.
Curse?
This is the real horror.
Her blood-covered hooves. Dun, dun, dun. The body of the mare was withering away, blood escaping from underneath her body.
Good lord!
Once again, same blood too many times. It really kills the magic, all this repetition.
Good lord! With all these dark imagery, you think every pony in Ponyville has an issue?
Well, at least Fluttershy and Pinkie Pie do. Anyway, oh, we have a solid snake moment here.
Mother! Mother!
Dun-dun-dun-dun! And funny enough, Phantom Pain came out recently.
Yes, apparently it's a good game. Go figure. The filly cried as tears of blood... No, normal tears. Not tears of blood. There are no tears of blood in this story, I hope. My immortal flashbacks. Tears of not blood began to stream down her eyes, shaking her mother's body to wake her, to tell her everything was all right. The music from the box died.
When the music from the box died. No, it doesn't work that way.
The body of the filly's mother turned to dust. See? What did I tell you?
And it
vanished in the wind, leaving nothing but the blood that had been spilled. Meanwhile, the dusted corpse is going on to star in the game Flower. Well, that was morbid.
Yeah, that was a very morbid thing to say. Especially about someone's mother. What is wrong with you?
Yes, well, it's wrong with me. Clearly, it's wrong with me. The filly shook and cried, tears drenching her cheeks. She touched the... What?
I was just crying.
Okay. Yeah, I thought it was... You were laughing. She touched the blood stain on the floor, trying to feel any remaining heat that told her that her mother was still there. The blood was cold. No sign of life to it. The music box started to play music once more, but it no longer played a sad but beautiful song. The music box hissed a horrifying sound as if bees suddenly filled the box. I'm trying to channel my Mark Nicholson, because I had Mark actually read parts of this story for my original review of it, as well as the first one. Anyway, we should get Mark onto this.
Oh, God.
Anyway, as bees in the field box,
the Billy and Bimmy.
The hillbilly filly. The filly looked up into the darkness, terror filling her core. Red eyes gleamed as a presence made itself known. It towered over the filly as it drew closer, its body cloaked in darkness. I think if it were to be cloaked in light, it wouldn't have been as impressive.
Or twilight.
The darkness itself flickered and flowed off of its body, its mouth opening, revealing a gaping hole of white filled with a hole of white filled with jagged black. Nothing that I just read make any sense. The presence of the creature crushed the filly. She couldn't move. She couldn't breathe. She was paralyzed by the very thing that stood before her. With a single swift movement, the creature closed the distance. Can I get my award now?
No, you haven't done yet.
For most dramatic reading ever.
No, you haven't done yet.
Its teeth sunk into the filly's neck, lifting her up and holding her as if a prize. Okay, this seems like that final scene in Five Nights at Freddy's 4 with the child stuck inside the mandibles of the animatronic. You know?
Yeah.
Lovely. Tears continued to stream down the filly's face as the blood slipped down her body. The creature growled before dropping the filly on top of the dust of her mother. Jeez, man. The filly could do nothing but stare into the darkness of the world. Even that darkness was soon fading into a separate darkness. What is this? Compartmentalized darkness? Seriously?
Yes, you too can even own a part of darkness in your own home.
Jeez. Do you buy darkness from IKEA? Or IKEA, if you live in America?
Or anyway, England.
The filly's vision was filled with the beast. Its jagged wife...
You're about to say wife? Jagged wife mouth?
Its jagged white mouth turned into a grin as it once more drew its teeth at the filly's face! All right. Now it's your turn to read. Good luck.
Fluttershy awoke with a scream. She panted heavily as she sat, staring at her pillow in the darkness.
The darkness! Which, I remind you, it's compartmentalized.
and can separate. The covers hanging on her shoulders. Her body soaked in sweat.
She has shoulders?
The cool night air.
She does.
The cool night air filled her burning, aching lungs. She put her hoof to her face, feeling the fresh tears that had been streaming from her face. She hiccuped softly as she tried to rub them away, still feeling fresh ones, wanting freedom as well.
Freedom for the tears, populace!
Something rustled under the covers next to her as she froze, turning as she heard the moan of something waking up.
Well, I hope it's a jump scare. I love jump scares. Another one!
Oh, gosh. You sued her. Ugh. Rainbow Dash groaned.
Hey, best pony's here.
Sitting up from her spot on the bed, rubbing her eyes.
How many is that now? At least 10.
10 out of 10.
10 out of 10. I'm too fast.
She let out a yawn, obviously still not used to being woken up in the middle of the night constantly.
I'm sorry.
Fluttershy hiccuped.
Thank you for the sound effect, by the way.
Oh, you gotta immerse the readers to the story.
If the reader wanted to be immersed in the story, they would have read them on their own. Or, you know, listen to a professional dramatic reading, not just this improvised improv that we're doing.
Okay. Squeezing her eyes shut as she desperately tried to hold back her tears, her body shaking.
I keep waking you up. I shouldn't have asked you to try and comfort me.
Okay, this is a bit too much stuttering even for my liking.
It's taking too long to read, too.
It's like Popeye. I keep
waking you up. I shouldn't have asked you to try and comfort me.
Okay, from now on, you read Fluttershy as Popeye then.
Oh, no!
You brought this upon yourself!
Gosh, no!
For a while, at least.
Fluttershy stuttered her words.
Oh, gee, you don't say.
Lumps forming in her throat as tears escaped her shut eyelids.
Okay, so far, this narration tends to go into a bit of purple prosy territory. It seems like it's trying to emphasize everything it's describing. For no other reason than the author's own amusement. Really. Which is counterproductive to the fact that it keeps falling into amateurish mistakes of repeating the same words way too many times in the course of one paragraph. I am a literary critic.
We can tell.
I'm actually not, but I can totally pose as one.
You poser. Anyway, you have an epic line here.
Ugh.
Perfect! You get an Emmy Award for that.
An Emmy Award for reading?
Yes.
Sure, why not?
And saying ugh. Rainbow put her hoof to her face. She shifted on the bed before wrapping her hoof comfortably around her mare friend's shoulders.
Once again, I remind you, mare friend is a thing. It's a term that exists.
Yeah, girlfriend is too normal, apparently.
You have to horse pun in eyes everything.
Yes, we have to horseshoe everything in.
Yes, every name of every town, and so on.
Fluttershy leaned into Rainbow's chest and sobbed softly into her.
Come on, Shy! You should know by now that me sleeping isn't as important as you feeling better.
I don't believe you for a fair second.
Why? She didn't give you any reason to not believe her.
I know, but still. The way it sounds.
That's because of me reading it.
Yeah, maybe.
Okay, you want to be downright sarcastic? Come on, Fluttershy. You should know by now that me sleeping clearly isn't as important as you feeling better. Emphasis on better.
Do you feel better about it?
Okay, let's move on. Can we actually quicken the pace?
Yes, I'm trying. Rainbow said quietly, lowering her head closer to Fluttershy's... Fluttershy. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh wait, there's a full stop there. To Fluttershy's. Fluttershy didn't reply, only continuing
You could have just used a pronoun there.
Yes. Her soft sobs.
So me spending the last few nights here hasn't helped your nightmares. That's no good. I mean, that's no big deal. It just shows you... It just shows us how serious this is.
Yes, we need to see a professional about this.
We need to see Twilight, obviously.
Rainbow said, trying her best to offer comforting words. Something she wasn't too used to.
Can you tell?
Fluttershy could only let out a whimper in response.
Beep.
The nightmares terrified her. She was barely able to fall asleep anymore, knowing that they were waiting for her inside her own mind.
A period was meant to be here, but it's not.
Because there's a capitalized S for she here.
Yes, so there is a missing period. Oh my. What I just said sounded all kinds of wrong.
Yes, maybe we should replace it all periods with Steve's then.
Okay, there is a missing Steve.
Thank you, American Dad joke. The only good joke.
Well, there were a few good ones.
Yeah. Okay, let me continue. She didn't want to sleep anymore. She wanted to stay up and be rid of the dreams. But her body was exhausted. It demanded sleep. But her mind screamed to stay awake. The conflict inside her only brought out more tears.
I think Devar is trying to outread me.
No, I'm always doing this.
Also, there was a Steve at the end of the sentence, so it's okay. Remember when I said that this story tended to retrace some aspects of the previous one?
Yeah.
Well, it pretty much began in the same exact way. The main character having a nightmare.
Mm-hmm.
And waking up to that nightmare and not knowing what to do about it. The only difference is that, well, there is a Rainbow Dash in this.
And a Fluttershy.
And the other one, Rainbow Dash, was just being killed in a dream. Because that dream was actually the story Cupcakes.
Yeah.
And all that.
Yes. Rainbow looked out into the darkness of Fluttershy's room as she tried desperately to think of something to do or say.
If only I was a smarter... Ding!
Rainbow, idea. Rainbow Dash thought to herself. It was as if a light bulb had been turned on in Rainbow's mind.
Yes. No, guys, this is the worst idea ever. Who died and decided that Twilight Sparkle is the authority in dreams? You'd think the shaman zebra in the forest would be a more appropriate, you know, candidate for this. But no, let's go to our smart friend that doesn't know anything about what she's doing, ever.
I'm trying to remember if we said this before with Zakora. Yeah, in the last story.
You know, we might as well have, for all I remember. Anyway. Fluttershy, in the morning, let's go see Twilight. I'm sure she can help us, help with these nightmares. I mean, she's got all kinds of books. This is me face palming.
And I face palmed as well.
I'm sure she'd have something that can help with this.
Why am I thinking Barry Burton with Rainbow Dash?
Well, careful, Fluttershy. You were about to become a Fluttershy sandwich.
Oh, no. That doesn't quite work.
Fluttershy, you better take this with you since you are the master of unlocking.
Rainbow spoke eagerly, but softly, making sure Fluttershy heard her.
Yeah?
Do you really think she can help?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Fluttershy asked, managing to wipe her face as a sob softened.
Yeah, of course she can. The worst part is, they are going to be warned about this. And they're still going to do it.
Rainbow said confidently, nuzzling up against Fluttershy.
She's Twilight. Even if she can't find an answer, she can ask Celestia. Of course, let's go bother the freaking ruler of all Equestria for a personal problem. Because the rulers most certainly have the time to do that. We'll get rid of these nightmares before you know it.
And if that doesn't work, we'll ask Applejack.
Yes. Perfect. She's the second smartest pony I know.
Jesus Christ. Thank you.
Fluttershy smiled softly, the tears finally stopping.
Okay, by the time they stop, they have a lake around the bed.
Cry me a river.
No, a lake, not a river.
Cry me a sea.
I said a lake! Oh, never mind. Hey, what's a mare friend for?
dating, kissing, watching movies, making fun of said movies.
Yes, reading fan fictions together. I think I just broke the bar.
Reading books in bed together. Oh no, I made it worse.
Pretty much. Anyway.
Rainbow.
Okay. When I finally visit good old England, wherever you live.
No, don't be in my bed.
We're going to be tucked into bed together. No! Like a sketch from Laurel and Hardy's old films. We're going to be trying to read a book together.
Oh no. Rainbow grinned, kissing Fluttershy's forehead. Only the forehead.
Careful, Dabar. Careful what you wish for.
I still don't feel like sleeping, though.
Fluttershy said, staring at the pillow of her bed. It was still deep in the middle of the night.
So my merfriend has trouble sleeping. What could I possibly do that only I can do to make her fall asleep?
I know, I'll get a hammer.
Great idea, let's get on to it.
Rainbow said and fought. Said and fought? I think that's pretty much just her humming.
Okay, the author is clearly feeling smart.
She wasn't sure what to say for that. She looked up at the ceiling and she fought again, apparently, twice.
You don't really have to think too hard about it, Rainbow.
As she thought about it, she then let off a small shrug, unintentionally like bloody Cloud Strife.
Alright, everybody, let's mosey.
As a thought rolled through her mind.
I guess it's now or never, then.
Oh, was it what? We're going to go knock on Twilight's door in the middle of the night and go like, hey, buddy, Fluttershy's having really bad nightmares. We thought you could help out.
Not quite.
Huh?
Fluttershy said, confused as she felt herself being pushed down onto the bed. I can see where this is going. Everyone get your popcorn. She looked up at Rainbow Dash as she lay on her back. Rainbow climbing on top of Fluttershy before kissing Fluttershy deeply.
And fanfictions were written. Oh, wait, what am I saying? That's insane.
Fanfictions write fanfictions.
Well, Fallout Equestria Project Horizons was written, so yeah, it can happen. Don't worry. I'll take your mind off of those nightmares so you can finish resting.
You big silly goose.
Giggity.
Rainbow grinned, blushing deeply. Fluttershy blushed in return. Really? I don't imagine Rainbow blushing.
Maybe this was the first time for the both of them.
Oh. Surprised, but accepting as she closed her eyes. Their lips meeting once more.
And Brony blocked.
Yes, because we just got Brony blocked to the next paragraph. So I think this is Madhog's turn.
I mean, we're technically not bronies, but you get the idea. Teasing, and then the paragraph ends, and that just stays there implied. Which is a good thing, by the way. We wouldn't be reading this story if there were to be any actual, you know...
getting together with the bedfellows.
Explicit content, let's put it like that. Also, it kind of speaks volumes of how much we are desensitized about these sort of things that we don't even bat an eye when it is implied that the two cartoon horses are about to get it on.
Each to their own, I say.
Yes. Then again, we've been making bestiality jokes pretty much for the entirety of King's Quest IV, so...
You were making them.
Well, you
don't drag me into this.
You were responding to them, so you're already drag in it.
Oh, come on, that's unfair.
Anyway, okay. Change of paragraph, which means it's once again the master's turn.
Yeah, because you've got Madhog by master, isn't it? Okay.
Thank you, Devar, for explaining that. Yes. We truly couldn't have done it without you.
Yes, we couldn't have done it with good old Jeff.
Again with Jeff.
Shouldn't you clear the clouds?
Question Steve? It's a question mark, but it's a question Steve, because we decided that periods are Steve's from now on, so yes.
Questioning Steve.
Question Steve. Fluttershy asked, yawning as her and Rainbow walked through the town, the warm sun only slightly obscured by a few clouds lingering around the sky.
That was the most scariest thing ever to come out of your mouth.
Thank you. You mean even scarier than me singing that song?
No, more scary than the story altogether.
All right. This is more important.
Now this is a good thing.
Rainbow said, rubbing Fluttershy's head lightly. I can clear the clouds in a snap, which you can't because you don't have fingers to snap with. Let's get you feeling better first. Rainbow grinned.
By the way, Fluttershy is not a dog.
maybe they're into SMN, you know.
You mean masters and slave?
I mean Sado and Maso.
Ah.
I suppose.
Fluttershy rubbed her eyes. Yes, that's what she rubbed. Still trying to rid them of sleepiness, she had started to develop bags under her eyes, repeating eyes too many times. Am I the only one who's noticing all this?
Yes, you're noticing it, but I'm also noticing it as well.
Anyway, from the lack of sleep, but nothing severe. Suppose nothing, it is more important, Rainbow said, trying once more to build Fluttershy's confidence. Just focus on getting better. Everything else can wait till then.
Getting better?
It's her.
Oh, so who should be her then?
Getting better? Is Fluttershy sick? Rainbow Dash and Fluttershy stopped as they looked behind them, seeing Pinkie Pie standing behind them with a basket. filled with letters. Oh, hey, Pinkie Pie. It sure is random for you to be so blatantly shoehorned into our story. Anyway, Rainbow said, turning to smile at her. Their pink friend.
Yeah, their pink punk friend.
And no, she's not really sick. She's just been having some really bad nightmares lately. So we're going to see Twilight if she can help. The silence was almost deafening despite its brevity.
This speaks volumes about how stupid this plan is.
This is the dumbest plan ever. The basket in Pinky's hoof fell, hitting the ground with what seemed like a loud thud. In slow motion, even. The letters spilling out before it. Ave Maria plays in the background. Nightmares? Nightmares? Pinky stuttered, a look of shock on her face. Pinkie, you drop your basket. Jeez, thank you, Rainbow. Rainbow said, pointing to it. No time for that! Pinkie said quickly, rushing to Fluttershy's side. She looked Fluttershy over, causing the yellow Pegasus to flinch a little before Pinkie looked into her face. How bad are these nightmares? How long have you been having them?
They're awful.
Fluttershy squeaked, answering, though intimidated by Pinkie's actions.
I've been waking up crying for the last week and a half now. I thought Rainbow Dash could help make them go away, but they still haven't stopped. So Rainbow suggested we go see Twilight.
Greatest idea, by the way. I don't know if we hammered that hard enough about how good of an idea that is.
Especially after last time.
Yep.
With Pinkie.
There is no excuse this time. And you know, the worst part is that this is going to happen one more time in a story written by some other guy that was actually placed in continuity with this whole saga.
Oh gosh.
It's dumb. Anyway,
Pinkie stared.
Pinkie stared, mouth agape at Fluttershy. Fluttershy began to sweat a little. Not understand.
Yeah, I not understand.
Not understand what was going through the pink pony's head. Pinkie Pie then looked serious for a moment before turning her head from Fluttershy, as if she was in serious mental contemplation. I see.
Oh, going gosh!
What?
Keep reading!
I see. Going to see Twilight is the natural assumption to make.
That was as natural!
Since when?
Since the Martians from Mars took over your planet? What is wrong with you people? Well, I mean, ponies.
Pinkie mumbled to herself. Pinkie Pie, what's going on? You're acting even stranger than you normally do. Rainbow looked at Pinkie Pie, confused by her actions. A comma should have been put there, but anyway. It's nothing. Perhaps she should have told them.
Yeah.
Maybe all this could have been avoided. Pinkie lied, stepping back from Fluttershy. But I'm going to Twilight's with you. And that's the story of how Pinkie Pie was shoehorned in this story.
And this is the story of how Pinkie Pie became the Ash Williams of the Silent Ponyville saga.
And that's the story of how Pinkie Pie became your mother.
And that's the story of how Pinkie Pie gave birth to all of Equestria.
Sure. We probably should have stopped at Pinkie Pie becoming your mother. Because the joke was obvious at that point. Anyway, I'm going with Twilight's... It sounded more like a demand than an offer.
It's okay, Pinkie.
I'm going with you!
Sounds like a Japanese man in voice acting.
I'm going with you!
Seriously, it reminded me of Japanese voice acting in anime.
Pinkie interrupted Fluttershy. Nani? Not backing down. Why would Pinkie Pie back down? If anything, Fluttershy, I see Fluttershy backing down. Rapidly from this.
Okay.
Fluttershy meekly agreed as Pinkie then nodded, taking the lead in heading to Twilight's house.
Who died and made you the leader of this expedition?
Well, she's the veteran from the first story. She should have been at peace now. She shouldn't have to relieve all this. Anyway, that's what bothers me the most. Rainbow Dash looked at one of the scattered letters on the ground, picking it up and looking at the pink envelope curiously.
What's gotten into you, Pinkie Pie?
Without the U.
What's gotten into Pinkie Pie?
Fluttershy asked, looking at Rainbow Dash, confused about what just happened. I don't know, and that's no good. But she just pulled off inviting us to a party for it. Well, that's serious. Rainbow showed the envelope to her.
Pinkie Pie was going to invite them to a nightmare party.
Maybe a corpse party, if it becomes cupcakes.
Oh, no.
Wow. This is serious.
That's what she said in a bit of a shock.
And they took Pinkie Pie to the hospital.
Hey, come on, we need to get to Twilight's house. Like, right now. Like, right the hell now. Pinkie Pie called out to the two mares after realizing they hadn't immediately followed. I think it's best if we do what she says for now. Rainbow said, not wanting to chance, thinking what else a serious Pinkie Pie might do.
Right.
Fluttershy agreed as the two of them quickly followed after Pinkie. Oh, I'm having a sense of deja vu.
Oh yes, I'm having that as well, because now we've gone to the next paragraph. And I'll be Twilight here.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, hey, Pinkie Pie.
Twilight, no time to explain!
There's no time to explain!
We've got to travel back into time and prevent you from having sex with your mother! Anyway. Twilight, we've got a serious problem! Wait, that sounded too bulky. Twilight! We got a serious problem!
Pinkie barged into Twilight's house without giving the purple unicorn a chance to pose a greeting.
Do you have to pose to greet someone?
Let's see. Hand on hip, other hand raised up in the air, guys, and wave like the queen!
Alright. And I mean a problem that as big as the last time I visited you with a problem. Wait, is this all taking place in 1 week?
Yeah,
that's fine. Because you guys have one problem a week, and you always go to Twilight for that. So, yeah.
Huh? Do you mean the nightmares are back?
Twilight asked, a little confused, looking Pinky over.
But your mane is fine.
Congratulations!
Because our emotions are determined by how our mane looks.
It's the clear sign of insanity.
Oh no, the problem isn't with me this time,
Pinkie said, pointing out the door she had just so casually walked through. Twilight turned her head to see a rainbow dash, quickly walking in as well.
It's a wild rainbow dash! I'm gonna catch it!
Yes, just throws a leash on it.
Well, there is an animation called Misty vs. Rainbow Dash, or something like that.
Oh, gosh.
So, yeah. Jeez, Pinkie, was running here really important?
Rainbow huffed as she moved past Twilight.
This is a big deal, sure, but Fluttershy's no good at high-speed pursuits.
And Pinkie
Oh, but there was a need to rush, Dashy! Trust me on this one, we need to fix ASAP!
Pinkie tried to get Rainbow to understand.
Is Dash having the problem?
Is that time of the month already? Is she having a missing Steve?
No, she's missioning her question, Steve.
Well, let's call exclamation Steve and help in the search of question Steve.
We'll have to ask semicolon Steve.
Why not comma Steve? Oh, wait, that's a comma, not Steve. Anyway,
Twilight asked, looking curiously at her rainbow-haired friend.
Wow, that rainbow is so majestic, I want to eat it. I bet it tastes like Skittles.
Taste the rainbow, mother freaker!
No.
Well, too bad, I just said it.
No, it's not her.
Pinkie said, pointing to the door once more. Twilight turned once more. Ugh! Once more! Do we have to have a once more counter as well?
No. Also, why is she turning constantly? I mean, does she have several different entrances in our house placed at every angles of it, because she keeps turning every time.
All you have to do is turn. All right.
Okay, she turned once more.
To see Fluttershy slowly making her way in as well.
And then she says, oh, that makes sense.
Sorry for the interruption, Twilight. I hope we aren't disturbing you from anything important.
Fluttershy apologized.
No. I was just getting ready to, solve a world hunger. But that can wait for you.
No, it's no trouble, Fluttershy. I was just catching up on some studying and playing some Heroes of the Stallion.
That pun again. Okay, I just accidentally hit my headphones.
Because he was that mad about it. Twilight
smile. No, because I am entangled in various cables right now. I'm like Lane in Serial Experiment Lane.
Oh dear.
Cables everywhere.
Twilight smiled comfortingly. But is something troubling you, Fluttershy?
I think everyone has pointed this out already.
Can we get to the point? Can we get to the Steve?
Yes.
Oh, well, yes, actually. That's why we came to see you.
Fluttershy said, scraping a foot against the ground.
Ponies do not have feet! Damn it!
I've been having trouble sleeping.
I'm also having trouble walking because I have feet all of a sudden.
I had hands too, and with fingers. What fingers?
And
was hoping you could help.
Trouble sleeping, nothing.
Rainbow said, moving to stand next to Fluttershy.
Fluttershy's been having some nasty nightmares. They've been keeping her up, and me as well. She's unable to sleep, and she dreads having to go to bed. Except when we do it. We were. Okay, now this is how it's written.
We were.
Oh, we apostrophe er. So yes, the apostrophe is not supposed to be there. We were hoping you could help out, Twilight.
Okay, let me. Dash explained in more detail.
Well, I do happen to have one spell I know of that works. One of...
No!
Twilight's word became muffled as a pink hoof was jammed into her mouth.
Thank you. No. We're not using that spell. Why did Pinkie Pie not tell Twilight what she went through? I mean, she had no reason not to tell her.
Yeah, that's what I'm wondering.
Why not?
Twilight asked. After removing the hoof from her mouth. Oh, you sure it's not her foot?
Or her hand.
Yeah.
Or some other alien limbs we're not being informed of. Maybe she has tentacles too. 'Cause we are not.
Well, that explains a lot, Pinkie. Thank you. Pinkie said, closing her eyes, as if not wanting to budge.
We've got to find a way to make this all okay. We have to find some other way to help Fluttershy.
Like Sakura. But...
Or maybe, the princess that can walk into Pony's dreams. Then again, this was written in 2012, so at the time we weren't already aware of that particular fact about Princess Luna. So it's justified.
Yeah. But the spell worked so well last time. Why shouldn't I use it now?
Because it actually worked, that's why.
Twilight was very confused. Pinkie Pie had explained to her that the spell had let her come to terms with the tragedy of her sister's passing. But she hadn't explained what exactly happened during the spell that led to the revelation.
Well, now it's a good time to explain, actually.
Yeah, in the Silent His Ponyville spin-off series, Silent Ponyville Revelations.
I'm going to kill you.
All Twilight had been seen during the delve was what appeared to be a warped picture sitting amidst a foggy backdrop. As she had tried to study the picture, it kept changing before her till the mind delve disconnected itself in a flash of light.
Trust me, Twilight, using it on Fluttershy will end badly, so we're going to help her without it. Yes, let's have some good long sessions of therapy. It might take some time, months, even years, but eventually you'll be able to come to terms with what is haunting you, and now no time for that. Let's do the fast way, I guess. The potentially deadly one.
But it'd be so much easier to just use the spell. It only takes a few minutes, and I'll have helped her with the nightmares. Doesn't that make sense?
Twilight tried to battle Pinkie with her logic, an already losing battle, because she doesn't work on logic.
You know, Pinkie Pie, you really need to explain things. Even if he does, it's still not happening.
Pinkie retorted back. Fluttershy and Rainbow looked at each other, very confused, as Pinkie and Twilight went back and forth. They had no idea what their friends were talking about.
So, what exactly are we doing to help Fluttershy then?
Rainbow finally asked, interrupting the back and forth between the two bickering ponies.
Ugh, fine. I'll go find my copy of Dreams, A Psychological Understanding.
Why don't you consult a professional? You know, someone who actually studied specifically for the purpose of helping ponies with psychological problems.
Well, if there's anything to do with the horse that thinks he's a dog comes to mind, then maybe that explains a lot about the psychiatric ward.
Well, I like to think she was a really desperate case.
Twilight said, walking away from the pink mare, who sat there looking victorious.
Her name is Screwloose, by the way. Screwloose, unsurprisingly.
Yeah.
Thank you, Twilight. I assure you this will be the best for everyone. Well, this was a short story.
Yep, this is a very short story.
Okay, here's the problem with this. Here's the problem with stories like this, which is also the problem of the first story. You really have to have characters act really stupidly in order to get any sort of story going. If they were smart, there wouldn't be any story. Unfortunately.
Ugh.
It's kind of irritating. There has to be a way to write a story starring smart characters that still get into trouble in spite of, you know, doing everything right.
Like in reality.
Pretty much.
Pinkie then bounced over to Fluttershy, putting her hoof around her shoulders without a head, apparently, while offering a comforting smile.
Don't worry, Fluttershy. I promise we'll make your bad dreams go away.
You really think this will work?
Fluttershy looked at Pinkie for hope.
If any pony can help make things better, it's Twilight. I'm sure of it. I'm not even going to protest that supposed fact.
Yes.
Pinkie smiled happily. Can you smile sadly?
Yes. Yes, you can.
All right,
Twilight said, returning with a floating copy of the book, opening up and flipping through several pages.
Places. I think he meant to say pages.
The first thing I should do is see what kind of dreams you're having. Since we won't be jumping straight to the Mind Delve spell, there's other solutions listed here that might work depending on the severity of your dreams.
Twilight explained before placing the book down on the table in the center of her house.
How will you know that?
Fluttershy asked curiously.
There's a spell in this book that will let me see the dreams you have been having. I'll be able to judge myself how severe they are.
Twilight said, walking over to Fluttershy.
But...
Fluttershy began to protest.
Don't worry, Fluttershy. Twilight knows what she's doing. Right?
No.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sure.
She got a Nobel Prize in this, I'm sure.
Rainbow asked, while trying to comfort the worried Pegasus. Of course. Now this will only take a moment.
Twilight smiled, not waiting for Fluttershy to give another response, before gently sweeping hair away from her forehead and tapping her glowing horn against the Fluttershy's forehead.
The Fluttershy's forehead?
So we have to go Bill Oddie with this now.
The Fluttershy's forehead, which, might I add, has a nice, soft mane to it.
So, dreams again. Unlike the previous story, they are not put all at once at the beginning. They are scattered throughout the first chapter. And much like the first story, the first chapter is kind of boring.
Okay.
All right, it's my turn. I know. I don't want to fly! The words screamed again and again, bouncing on her skull, driving her mad. Her wings were beating as fast and as strong as they could, despite every ounce of her being telling her to stop them. Her whole body was crying out for relief, pain filling her back and legs. Her wings were bent, horribly mishappen, not even looking
misshapen.
Like they should. Why did I say mishappen?
Because you thought there was a extra P in there.
Oh, misshapen. Not even looking like they should lift her. But they carried her through the sky. Tears swept across her face as every flap sent pain shooting through her back, scratching away at her mind, eroding her sanity. Eroding her sanity, oh my.
That's quite a nice way of putting it.
A loud roar pierced her ears and shook her whole being. Her head painfully but slowly turned to look behind her as a giant figure appeared from behind the clouds, billowing smoke as it soared at high speeds straight for her. Her legs flailed, feeling... What?
Sorry, it's just the word flail, just, you know, in cartoon animation, just makes me laugh.
Okay. Her legs flailed, feeling as if every movement snapped a bone and tore her muscles.
Ooh.
The large beast opens its jaws before its gigantic teeth sunk straight down into her flesh.
Wait, there's a break here.
It's all dreams.
Ah.
Do you want to read the next one?
You know what, yes, I'll be a part of this.
By all means.
She wanted to scream, but no voice came to her. She wanted to close her eyes, but her body would not obey her. She wanted to shut down and die, but her body did not comply. The swirls of tortured screams filled every inch of her. Twisted faces and horrified cries screamed out to her. One word repeated itself endlessly in her mind.
Pain!
Pain! Pain! Pain! Pain! Pain! Pain! Pain! Pain! Pain!
Pain! It's repeated about 40 times.
Pain, pain, pain.
In
pain,
red.
Pain, 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 pain. Wonderful pain.
There was nothing to decipher, only the red horror that swirled around her.
It bellowed and cried. It screeched and it hollered. But suffering would not end.
Devar, would you like to read Lovecraft next?
Is that a compliment or is that just...
No, no, it's a compliment. This kind of completely super emphatic, horrific, creepy, dreadful kind of reading. It's perfect for reading Lovecraft.
Ah, okay.
Neither would hers. Everything assaulted her mind. She felt the pain as every fiber of her being was destroyed by the horror before her.
Hmm. Can I top that? I don't think so.
Yeah, you can try, because there was a break.
Yes, I know. I know.
Oh, that did my throat in, though, slightly. Mm. It's been a long while since I did anything like that for stage work.
Her knife came down. It struck its target. She brought the knife back up. She swung it down. Her target hit again. Her actions repeated again and again. One fluid motion after the other, her knife struck the body before her. She was coated already, coated in the warm liquid she has caused to splatter all over. Each fresh strike sent another burst of the warm liquid against her body. A smile was on her face, one that had been there a long time as she had started. She made fresh holes and fresh liquid with each strike, plunging the knife in and out of the pony before her seemed to bring satisfaction. Before her seemed to bring satisfaction.
I'm trying to understand this.
Yeah. They deserve this. She deserved it to be the one to do this to them. This is how it was supposed to be. She plunged the knife down one last time, panting as she looked excitedly at her work. The punctured body didn't move or twitch. It just laid before her. The body would never move again. She tossed the knife to the side and leaned forward, nuzzling the body as she smiled. This was love. Craft.
Baby, don't hurt me no more.
Well, what do you think of that?
Well, it has its own charm to it, I say.
No, me reading, that is.
Ah, yeah. It was not bad. I personally like the, you know, different
I was trying to start off slow and then grow more emphatic as the text goes on.
Ah.
You know, to match the building of the suspense, you know, up until it climaxes.
Yeah, I get that. It's but to be honest, I actually like the different ways we try to send this across, because it's like the dreams. It's chaotic.
Yes. Chaotic.
Anyway, we're back in reality now.
Now it's your turn again.
Twilight stepped back as the memories of the dreams filled her mind. She grimaced as her stomach did a flip. A knot forming in her throat.
A flip knot.
They were horrific.
A slip knot.
A slip knot that turned into a sour stone.
Tell me if any of you people remember that happening when the singer of Slipknot tried to make another band called Sour Stone.
I'm sure there's somebody who remembers that out there.
Yeah, it was very strange to say the least.
They were horrific dreams. Dreams filled with pain.
Pain!
Suffering.
Suffering!
Insanity.
Insanity!
And loss.
And win! No, wait.
They weren't just simple nightmares.
No.
No. She had seen she had seen dreams like this before.
Are you okay, Twilight?
Fluttershy asked nervously, not sure what to expect Twilight's reaction to be.
You know, you could said her reaction to be.
Yes, I'm fine.
Twilight. Sorry.
Yeah, it's alright. Twilight finally managed to say after swallowing the knot in her throat.
You're awfully pale for being okay.
Rainbow said, looking at Twilight worriedly. She didn't think the nightmares would have been so bad as to make Twilight lose a shade of color.
Well, she still has all other shades of purple, so don't worry.
Yeah, she has 49 of them. Eh?
Well, ah ha ha, 50 shades of purple. Now I get it. Good job, Devar. Good flipping job. Now go to your room and think about what you've done.
Oh, I'm in my room already.
Go out to the room, then come back into your room and then think of what you've done.
Okay, I thought about it.
Okay. Pinkie. Well, you didn't go stumbling back into the bookcase this time. Were they not as bad? Oh yes, I remember this happened the first time too.
Oh yeah, deja vu. Pinkie
asked. Like I said, retracing the same moments.
Pinkie asked, tilting her head curiously. Oh, they're very, very bad. Twilight rubbed her head a little. But they're bad in a different way. I don't think I can make an accurate comparison. At the very least, they felt the same in intensity.
It seems like the author is rewriting the same story, but with slightly different details.
It's like a strange remake sequel. Or
it's like The Evil Dead 2.
It's like they tried. It's like it's a sequel make or resequel.
It's like Rob Zombie's Halloween, basically.
So, what do I...
A mess!
What do I do?
Fluttershy asked meekly. Hold on, I need to consult the book. Consult the book for everything, Twilight. That's your character. Twilight said, shaking her head lightly, before levitating it over to herself, flipping through some pages and reading a few passages. There's a lot of spells in here for more minor nightmares, soothing remedies, relaxation methods.
Why is your Twilight starting to slowly shift into Popeye for some reason?
It's not. I'm trying my best not to.
And magical psychology evaluations. But
Twilight sighed, looking at Pinkie.
With what I just saw, there's only one spell in here strong enough to find out what's happening in Fluttershy's mind.
Are you absolutely sure there's no other spell in that book? Like a solving the plot instantly spell? That would come in handy.
Or a sensible solution spell? Ugh. Okay. Pinkie asked, desperate to not have to turn to that answer.
I'm sure, Pinkie. The Mind Delve spell is going to be our best solution.
Jeez, I wonder what the worst solution is then.
Yes, I was actually wondering that as well. But I was going to say, is this going to be your answer to every problem, Twilight?
In a word, yes.
I'm having nightmares. Delve spell.
Done.
I broke my hoof. Mind Delve spell. I've got poop in my eye. Mind Delve spell.
Why did you jerk? That's sick.
I was referencing Scrubs for some reason.
Okay.
You know, Scrubs the musical.
Yes. That was a good episode.
Yes, it was amazing.
Anyway.
All right.
Don't die on me. Why are you so against using that spell, Pinkie? Explain, Pinkie. Explain.
Rainbow asked, looking strangely at her earth pony friend.
You said it helped you before. Why shouldn't we use it on Fluttershy?
Pinkie was silent. Silent Ponyville!
Silent Ponyville, yes, sure. Rub it in.
She thought about it for a moment before looking seriously at Twilight.
Twilight, read to me the spell's description.
You mean you didn't read the description of the spell? Twilight flipped back to the exact page of the spell and began to read. The mind delve spell is used in cases
where... actually, you should use your documentary voice for this one.
What, you mean the mind delve spell is used in cases where the nightmare or psychological problems are not so easily discernible?
Yes, perfect.
This often means that the problem is rooted deep within the patient's subconscious and can't be obtained through normal psychological methods. Without spending a very long time treating the patient, this spell allows the user to shorten the necessary time needed in order to bring the patient to a full recovery. Each patient the spell is used experiences different results, as the subconscious is molded by the patient who owns it. No two patients will likely experience the same recovery under the use of the spell.
This is a confusing mess of an explanation. It doesn't really explain anything.
Well, it explains the obvious that, you know, that every pony is different and has different issues that...
It doesn't say that it drags you into a mental version of the town you live in to fight against your worst nightmares and possibly die. Yeah.
Yes. Okay. Let's continue then. We've almost done, I think. I would hope. Pinkie thought about those words carefully. Something seemed to be spinning the wheels in her head.
Okay.
Pinkie finally said, breaking from thought.
We can use the mind delve spell on Fluttershy under one condition though. And okay,
no.
Here's the kicker. This will require all of your face palms. Have face palming hands at the ready. You'll need them all. All right, go on.
What? Twilight asked, blinking a little confused.
You had to find a way to put me into Fluttershy's mind when you do it.
You want...
Not yet. It actually gets better.
Really? I facepalmed too early?
Too early, yes.
Ugh. You want to go into my mind? Fluttershy asked, very surprised.
Fluttershy, I want me inside you.
I'm pretty sure this is somehow a jealous thing. Well, Rainbow Dash should be jealous about this somehow.
Well, funny you should be nailing that nail on the said coffin from before. Again.
Oh, no.
You seem to unconsciously predict things. Always.
Perhaps I've seen so many of these stories.
Pretty
and
much.
I can pick up on these things.
I won't let you go through this alone, Fluttershy. I'm going to be there with you to help you with your problem, because I'm your friend.
And I like to nose about into your family life. Pinkie said, turning her head slightly, shifting her mane so Fluttershy could see it better.
I wear this red ribbon as a testament that my friends are dear to me. That means if they're in trouble, then I'm going to help them. And I'm going to see you through this, Fluttershy, so that you can not only feel better, but so that you don't have to be alone while doing it. Yay.
While doing it, you say? Okay.
So it's a threesome?
Are you a bit of a voyeur, Pinkie? Pinkie smiled.
Okay. Now you'll need all your face palms.
Good. Pinkie smiled.
And then Rainbow says, well, then I'm going in too. Okay. Yeah. So all three of them inside Fluttershy's brain, basically. I was not sold with this story at the beginning, as you might imagine.
I wasn't sold on it in the summary. I'm not sold on it still, because that makes this story less interesting.
Actually, okay. Like I said, it starts off weak, very weak, but trust me on this, it gets much better.
Oh, I hope so, because usually when you include other people in a soul-searching story, it becomes less interesting.
It also becomes less scary because you're surrounded with people, so
yeah,
there is less a sense of isolation. Well, don't worry about that. I find a way to separate them pretty soon.
I think I facepalm so hard that that I'm seeing colors.
Anyway,
Rainbow said, stepping closer to Fluttershy.
I can't just let my mare friend do something like this without me. I'm going to be there for her till the very end. Because I'm Rainbow Dash. I'm loyal.
Also, I'm gonna be in first. Rainbow grinned, nuzzling against Fluttershy. Fluttershy blushed as she smiled softly.
Thank you both. Both of you.
Ugh. Twilight put a hoof to her face.
Thank you.
Yes, put that in the bottom corner of this title card thing. Twilight put a hoof to her face.
I don't even know how to do that.
Twilight said as she walked off towards the bookshelf.
You guys are going to have to give me a moment. There's nothing in dreams, a psychological understanding, that explains how to link minds together.
Just wing it.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, you don't have wings yet. Oh, snap.
Oh. She said as she began to levitate books off of the shelf, checking each title before pushing them off to the side. There was a distinct sound of her mumbling something about how she shouldn't have sent Spike on a shopping trip that day. Oh, yeah, nice way to write out Spike in this fan fiction.
This could take a while,
Rainbow said, looking at the other two mares.
Hey, let's play some games to pass the time.
Who wants to play Mare's Quest? Pinkie chimed in happily.
That sounds fun.
Fluttershy smiled.
All right, and change a paragraph, hopefully the last one.
Yeah, we hope so anyway. And I get to rest my vocal cords.
Anyway. King me! Pinkie grinned happily, having victoriously jumped several of Dash's pieces before arriving at the opposite end of the checkers board. Man, Pinkie, how you're so good at this! Rainbow furrowed her brow as she looked at the board.
I think you meant to say brow, but let's actually go with bro. Yo, she phoned him bro.
She was clearly losing for the fifth element time. Now, Pinkie had just obtained her third king. Here's a practice, Dashie. Pinkie chuckled as she awaited her opponent's next move.
I call shenanigans and lies and slander. Dash should not be so upbeat about losing.
I think you've both been doing very well.
Fluttershy smiled, having enjoyed watching the matches.
Okay.
Twilight suddenly declared very loudly, putting her book as she had been studying tirelessly down. You scared us to death, Twilight.
I think I've got something. By using a mixture of various spells, I should be able to get all of you to share in Fluttershy's mind, Delve. I don't know how well it will work at the moment. It's all a theory, but I've made theories work before. I can do it again.
Oh, God. Oh, Celestia.
Oh, Celestia and Luna.
Twilight nodded, walking towards her friends. Oh, good, I was getting tired of this game anyway, Rainbow said, standing up, waving a hoof at the board.
And then flipping the table.
Only because you were losing, Pinkie chuckled before hoping up as well. Before turning to Twilight. Before turning to Twilight and looking a little serious. Are you absolutely sure you can get this to work, Twilight?
Absolutely.
When have you ever known me to mess up a spell once? I was confident in how it worked.
Do you really want us to answer that, Twilight? Do you really honestly want us to answer that? You do not want us to answer that. Trust us.
Yes, we've seen your future.
Again, why are they going for Twilight? Why are they asking Twilight to help in this situation that she's clearly not professionally equipped to handle? Pinkie put a oof to her chin as she looked off to the side before mumbling under her breath. Well, not in continuity. Come on, seriously?
What was that?
Twilight asked, not having heard her well. Nothing, Pinkie smiled before turning to look at Fluttershy. Are you ready for this, Fluttershy?
I guess I'm ready as I'll ever be.
Which means no, she said, walking next to Pinkie. We'll have you feeling better in no time, just you wait. Rainbow Dash smiled, standing next to Fluttershy as well, smiling her confident smile. All right then,
here goes.
Nothing. Twilight's horn lit up, glowing brightly as she concentrated. She walked up to her three friends, who stood before her, before gently tapping her horn against each of their foreheads. A thin blue line attached to her horn that stretched from their foreheads with each tap. Jesus. The light surrounding her horn grew brighter as she stepped forward before tapping her horn against Fluttershy's forehead. In that instant, the world felt like it slipped from under Fluttershy's hooves. Everything felt hazy as her body almost felt numb. She couldn't keep track of her surrounding. Thought she felt like she was falling. She was failing already. The only indication she felt like she was moving was a sensation of wind rolling around her. She tumbled and fell through a hazy fog in her mind, unable to comprehend anything. She let out a sharp gasp as air... As air finally returned to her lung, she panted for a moment. Don't you dare panting! Don't you dare panting! I swear I'm going to... Before her eyes...
Madhog, the panting police!
Before her eyes... fluttered open. Shut up. She got her bearings slowly as the world began to come into view before her. She was still inside of Twilight's house. However, it was now missing that particular purple unicorn. Ugh, Twilight, what's the big idea? That spell? It was Rainbow's voice she heard next. She turned her head and saw her mare friend, already standing up, looking around for Twilight. Wait, where'd she go? I don't think I could ever get used to that. It was Pinkie's turn to speak up. Rainbow and Fluttershy looked behind them to see her groggily standing up. But I'm glad to see she got it to work. She smiled, seeing her two friends. What's going on, Pinkie? Where's Twilight? Rainbow asked, looking around, confused at their missing unicorn friend. Oh, that's normal. She's not going to be here with us, Pinkie said, looking around quickly. She got up and ran to a nearby window, looking out of it. She grew quiet as she stared out the window. We already know she was at the window, so you need... Never mind.
Pinkie Pie?
Fluttershy asked, looking at her friend oddly. What do you mean, oddly? Did she tilt her head and she's in a weird angle? Is this what you went through when Twilight helped you? Rainbow asked curiously. There was silence for a moment. Rainbow and Fluttershy looked at each other a little confused, before Pinkie finally spoke back up. Yes? She turned away from the window, looking at her two friends with a serious look. It's almost exactly the same as what I went through. and is exactly the reason why I said I had to come. Pinkie said, galloping across the library to a shelf before pulling a map out from it.
What do you mean?
Fluttershy asked as Pinkie brought the map over to the table, Fluttershy and Rainbow walking up to look at it. We're going to need this to keep track of where we are. Okay, so I like this. The Pinkie Pie is the veteran mind delver. Let's go with that.
Yes, she's the veteran. We're seeing a veteran at work now.
Pinkie explained, pointing to the map of Ponyville that she unfurled before them. Pinkie looked up from the map, seeing that a bag lay on the table as well. Fluttershy, you should be the one to take the bag. Pinkie explained, pointing to it.
But why?
Fluttershy asked, confused, grabbing the bag and pulling it closer to open it. Damn it, woman, just do as I say! We have no time for this! Alright. Trust me, we're going to need it. Is there some kind of instrument inside of it? Pinkie asked, seeing Fluttershy look inside. Almost as if an answer to Pinkie's words, a soft, almost haunting, almost haunting melody began to slowly play from the bag. Fluttershy carefully reached in, pulling out an old music box that was playing the soft tune.
This...
Fluttershy stared at the music box in shock.
This is the music box my mother owned.
What's it doing here? Rainbow asked, looking at it curiously.
I don't know. I lost it a long time ago. How did it get here?
Fluttershy wondered quietly. The music slowly faded to a stop as she continued to stare at the music box. Pinkie Pie rolled up the map of Ponyville before placing it in the bag. Come on, let's head out, Pinkie said, smiling at Fluttershy, before heading for the front door.
You just need Pinkie now to tote a double-barrel shotgun and then veteran cliché gained.
Well, what, do you want a chainsaw attached to her oof?
Yes, and she proclaims, this is my boomstick!
Groovy. Head out? Where are we going? Rainbow looked confused at her pink friend. We're going to Fluttershy's cottage. If we're going to find any answers, I think that's the first place we need to check. Pinkie explained as she opened the door. Answers? To the nightmares? No, to our bountiful flower collection. What do you think?
Yeah, I was gonna say.
Anyway, Rainbow fought in confusion. What does this strange place have to do with them? Why are we even here? Fluttershy gently put the music box back in the bag. As she listened to Rainbow Dash's questions, she closed the bag, which had a clasp of a blue and pink butterfly. She gently lifted the bag. How many times did he say bag just in the course of the last sentence?
It's the bag. What was this, like, was this for people that had 7-second memory of what an item is?
That seems like me when I was playing a Silent Hill game. She gently lifted the bag up and placed it on her back to carry with her. I can't say for sure what this place is. I think we're inside Fluttershy's mind. But at the same time, it feels too solid to just be our imaginations. Pinkie scuffed the floor softly as she explained. The only thing I know for sure is that we need to be ready for anything. You mean anything? I mean anything! Pinkie opened the front door, stepping outside.
Let's follow her.
Fluttershy said, smiling at Rainbow.
She seems to know what she's talking about, so we should follow her till we get our bearings.
Oh, all right. I suppose that makes sense. It does?
It does?
Rainbow said before following after Pinkie Pie. Fluttershy followed the same, stepping out of the front door of Twilight's house. Hey, what's with the weather? Rainbow cried in confusion. Fluttershy stood in shock at the sight she had seen. No, wait, that's the previous story. Fluttershy stood in shock. Ponyville had fallen into a thick fog. No building could be seen past a few feet in front of their eyes. And that concludes chapter one.
Oh my gosh, that was so long.
It was, wasn't it? Much longer than the first one. This story has longer chapters and more chapters to begin with.
Oh gosh. That...
And it has pretty much the same problems of the first story, since it's pretty much retracing most of the first story, minus a few more details.
Oh gosh.
But eventually it gets really good. Trust me on that. I mean, at least that's what my mom... At least that's what my memory of it is telling me.
Yes, your momory, apparently.
Murmury. And speaking of murmury...
Yes?
Okay, let's end it here.
Yes. I think it's been a long night for us all.
All right, so next time is chapter 2.
So, oh no, we're going on to chapter 6. Of course, for chapter 2.
hey, come on. This is not King's Quest 7.
Well, if you're like my twin brother, he basically said we can't count since we went from King's Quest 1 to 8, then to yes. 4, and then
well,
to 7.
Well, okay, clearly we did not plan to do it like that. But at the same time, we're not going for a chronological order. We're going for a thematic order. I still have to decide what the theme is. So, right. So this has been Silent Ponyville 2, Chapter 1. Join us next time when the horror begins anew.
Yes. Bring yourselves to see the cute little things become disturbed machinations of their own shadows.
Oh, I hope we get to see our favorite dead filly from last time.
Yeah, that was disturbing. That was disturbing.
Yes, that was disturbing. Definitely was this disturbing, as you put it. And by the way,
yeah,
there are going to be nurse ponies in this one.
Well, it had to be one.
They had to debut. At some point.
Just as long as we don't get a pyramid pony, we'll be fine.
No, we don't. We get an original main bad guy, actually.
Good.
See you next time, folks.
Take care. And sleep tight till the next nightmare comes.
I want to go to a wild dreams.
God damn it, Madhog. Can I get a second version of you to come strangle you? Good night, everyone. Take care.